In this video, we're going to look at the external server function. What problem does it solve? Well, you may find that certain students have issues with video. This could be a local issue on their computer or perhaps a company firewall that is blocking the video stream. I myself have had some students who work in financial services and their companies have very strict rules about the type of software that they can run on their computers. In most cases, though, they will have whitelisted Zoom, Teams, Google Meet, the type of services commonly used for business meetings. So the use case here is a student who can enter the classroom, but the video or often the audio won't work for them. Here are the steps to take. In the classroom, we just need to click on the settings button, video server, and you can see we have green, our default server, blue, which is a backup server, and also this external option. If I click here, it will disconnect our video and the audio connection as well inside the classroom and ask me for a meeting link. Here I enter the meeting link for my chosen platform. For example, in Zoom, you can find the link here, and in Google Meet, you can find the link here. Then you click launch. This will open the meeting for me in a new tab, or in the case of a platform like Zoom, it'll ask me to launch the app. The student also clicks on launch and you can connect to them in the new meeting room. Remember that you may need to admit the student to the meeting. Things to note, this meeting is not embedded in the classroom. It'll be in a new window or tab. If you're using Zoom or a similar platform, your student will also need to have that application installed, or they'll be asked to download and install it when they click launch, like this. Some tips for using this method. You can resize the Google Meet window and keep it to the side of your classroom window with whiteboard only mode enabled, like so. That's quite a smooth experience. With Zoom, there is the option to choose minimal view, and you can even overlay this little pop-up on top of your browser, right where the LearnCube video would normally be. Remember, when finishing your class, you should close both meetings because your student will still be connected and they can still hear you. I hope you found that useful, and remember, you can always contact LearnCube support if you're having difficulty with any of our features.